Georgina Beyer, a trailblazing activist who made history as the world's first openly transgender MP, has died aged 65. She stared down her opposers, stood strong in her mana. She was fierce, fearless, and fabulously unapologetic. Undoubtedly, Gina has left her mark on Aotearoa's political landscape. Friend and former Labour MP Louisa Wall is with us this morning to reflect on Georgina's life and legacy. Morena, Lou.
Morena,
I mean, I hate the fact that we have to be here talking about your beautiful friend in this way this morning, but I get to see you, so thank you for being with us.
Love you, my friend, and love our Georgie girl.
What have we lost, Lou?
We've lost somebody who was an anchor, I think, for the rainbow community. Somebody who I've started to conceptualise has brought the abstract to the concrete and made us understand what trans identities were and why it's so important for us to support our trans whānau. But also from a takatāpui perspective, someone who was also very clear that her identity was a gift from our tūpuna, and that based on her whakapapa, she had the right to stand as she was and to live a very open, honest and transparent life, and a life where she could be free from abuse, violence, which meant we were all free from abuse and violence. So an incredibly special person. I think she was a miracle when you read her life story.
Yeah.
And the experiences she had and the fortitude and the fact that she could stand to be mayor, to be a member of parliament and use her voice always to advocate for people who were vulnerable and disadvantaged.
Which is absolutely incredible, because you said briefly, given the life that she had, and I don't think we need to go too far into that, but it was a hard life, but yet...
It was a traumatic life.
Yeah.
It was a life where she experienced a lot of rejection, a life that she experienced violence, but one where she prevailed because she was always really clear about who she was, and unapologetically so. And she became herself, and she was a transsexual, and she was very proud of that identity. But I think the most phenomenal part of Georgie was that she used all of that and was very clear and transparent about those experiences, never hid the fact that she had been a prostitute, for example. And I think somebody that lives so authentically, yeah, does deserve our respect, and obviously got it. She got it from the people of Carterton, and she got it as a Member of Parliament, and she got it as a global icon who really has been an inspiration for many, including myself.
And I want to go there, because you talk about this icon, but who was she to you?
To me, she was a mentor. She was a friend. She was someone who was always with me. We shared many experiences, and someone we could debrief to about the opposition, you know, what comes from, you know, standing up and using your voice. And there was a lot of abuse, but it was so wonderful with Georgie, because it was almost like to hell with them, like literally. And it made you stronger and made your conviction, I guess, to see to an end, ending, you know, the criminalisation of prostitution, to ensuring marriage equality in our country, to standing up for trans people, for all of us to live a life of dignity and rights. And so she was very special to me, because she anchored me. And because of her experiences, you kind of just continue and you're prepared to fight the fight.
Can we talk
and
about
to represent our country, our community?
Can we talk about those experiences, because she was a trailblazer going into parliament. She paved the way, right?
She
but
did.
During that time, it was a hard road, and what she encountered during that time. So her work beforehand, what did that mean for you?
Well, she made it easier.
Yep.
She made it easier for a lot of us, and she did. In some ways, she scorched the earth so that we had, you know, a pathway and a passage where our advocacy added to her legacy. You know, and I'm really proud of a Māori woman who has done that on behalf of all of us for Aotearoa New Zealand. Not many people know she has a Y claim, Y703. Yep. It will be part of the kaupapa hearings. And Georgie wants to challenge the government about how Takatāpui identity was affected by colonisation, by the fact that the Crown needs to work with Takatāpui so that we can plan, develop and deliver our own health services. You know, so that's an active legacy that some of us now will have to take over and to drive forward. But she never stopped working and advocating for our community, never. And I think the message is, it's almost ka whawhai tonu mātou, right? Yeah. Struggle with our end. But it's an end where there are those that we stand on their shoulders, and she is one of those people. Mm. And I think we owe Georgie a huge debt of gratitude to dedicating her life to service.
The why claim that you're talking about, is that's the one that you both were working on?
She was working on it. I was trying to work with her, and actually it was about the relevance of colonialism to Indigenous Takatāpui or LGBTQ identities globally. We have been affected by colonisation specifically. Mm. We were criminalised. Mm. You know, and religious teachings have said that we don't have a right to exist. So I think that within the context of recent apologies, and I look to the Pope's apology in Canada about residential schools and the damage to Indigenous peoples and community, well, what about Takatāpui as an Indigenous identity? We've been severely affected by colonisation. Mm. So the fact that that's a live issue that she leaves as a legacy for those of us who are still in the game, and the game really of being proud of who we are and realising that the privilege we have means we have to use our voices to make the lives of our mokopuna better. Because we don't want people to go through what Georgie went through, and the abuse and the violence, that's just unacceptable and intolerable.
Hei whakatepe ake tā tātou kōrero I te atanei. Just to wrap things up, how will you remember
How will I remember her? Just as this most flamboyant, articulate, she was a scene stealer. And I mean that quite lovingly. She was a performer, but a performer that actually understood that she was our representative, and she was just gracious, and she had so much poise, but man, if you got on her wrong side, she would never back away. And that's what I will remember the most. We must keep progressing forward. Okay. Never stop.
Okay. Lou, thank you so much for being with us, and you held it together. Go you, good thing. Thank you for that beautiful, beautiful tribute to your beautiful friend. Lovely to see you too. Moi mai rā e te rangatira, moi mai rā e te marae, kura haere atu koe ki o tūpuna, oki oki ai. Go to your ancestors and rest easy.